conserving the lands and waterways so that plants and animals can thrive in their natural habitat is the prime objective for most watershed associations and river groups. Dam removals are quite often the means to achieve those ends, but that process usually takes a considerable amount of time and fundraising, with the emphasis on the latter. For the Nature Conservancy, they actually have a dam on one of their properties that won't require much of either and could be removed before the New Year's out. Connecting Point's Brian Sullivan traveled to the farthest southwest corner of Massachusetts to bring us this story.
This dam in Holyoke is just one of over 3,000 located in the Commonwealth. Since 1902, it's been one of the longest standing dams in the country and still serves as a major cog in the engine of Holyoke Gas and Electric. And just as others like the one here at Chicopee Falls or this one in Indian Orchard serve the purpose of generating hydroelectric power, there are plenty of others across the state whose original purpose is a thing of the past. While they might be nice to look at, the truth is their existence can sometimes be a hindrance on the health of the ecosystem. This is where an organization like the Nature Conservancy will step in and try to restore the original river connectivity that existed before. One way to achieve that is by tearing the dam down, like they did here in Leeds. The latest structure to be added to the chopping block can be found in the town of Mount Washington, Massachusetts, on this 1,500-acre tract of land that the Nature Conservancy purchased in 1999. The dam at Becker Pond is just one of more than 45 ecological sites designated as priority projects by the Baker-Polito administration. Getting there? Well, that took a little bit of doing.
To say this location is remote is a bit of an understatement. Some folks might be wondering how this dam was given priority project status by the state when it's in a town that has fewer than 200 people living in it. I wondered the same thing myself.
One reason might be the price tag. While some removals can cost in the millions, this one here at Becker Pond comes in at just under $100,000. But that price has more to do with the fact that no local infrastructure will be disrupted by the process. The priority designation is based on the ecological significance.
This is a dam that we're planning to remove because of the environmental benefits. This is a cold water stream. The fact that it's actually in a more remote area is part of the reason that it's a priority for ecological restoration. So by removing this dam, we're going to reconnect upstream and downstream habitat for species like brook trout, which like cold, clean water. Also removing the dam, we're getting rid of that warm water impoundment, which spills warm water downstream. So we're restoring the habitat for species that like that type of a stream.
Dams here in the state fall into three categories, according to the Massachusetts Office of Dam Safety: high, significant, or low hazard, depending on how its potential failure could impact human life and property. The impoundment at Becker Pond doesn't land under any of those headings. This was more a matter of dollars and common sense for the Nature Conservancy, all the while living up to their mission of protecting biodiversity, plants, and animals.
The dam has a big crack in one of what's called the retaining walls, which are the walls where the river's coming down through after it crosses the dam. And so there's also a bridge across the dam that people use to walk across it. Well, as you can see from these pictures, the bridge is kind of askew. It's not safe to walk on anymore. And soon the whole thing's going to fall in because the walls are going to break and fall into the stream. As a dam, if we were to keep the dam, we would have to fix it and maintain it, and that's very costly.
The conversion from dam to a free-flowing river system is also a means for the Conservancy to combat the Earth's climate change. Cold water fish, which are often seen as indicators of the overall health of the ecosystem, may be relegated to one small area due to the impoundments. The dam removal at Becker Pond is likely to increase the health of the fish and their surroundings.
What we really want to do is to create connected habitat, because when we have connected cold water systems, the fish within that system can move to seek refuge from hot weather or high flows. And so it's really the connected network that we're looking for.
That connectivity eventually includes the Housatonic River by way of about 6 degrees of separation. But as far as dams are concerned, on a personal level, I've always been fascinated by the beauty of the combination of human-made and nature-made. There's just something extremely New England about waterfalls and the giant granite structures that they spill over. And most, if not all of them, have been around for so long that they're the only landscape that members of the communities in which they reside have ever known. Taking them away because they don't serve a purpose anymore can be a bitter pill for those of us who find solace in the sight and sound of their presence.
a dam's usefulness depends on who you ask that question of. You know, for the Nature Conservancy, this mission is to protect biodiversity, plants, and animals. This does not help that our purpose. If we were landowners who use the pond for swimming and ice skating and those kinds of things, then we might decide it's still useful to us and fix it. But that's not our mission.